Pizza in the morning, pizza in the evening, pizza on a bagel. Eat it up every day.
Yo, what's going on, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Childhood Eats with me, Rome. Your boy. I recreate childhood memories. I give you the dose of nostalgia that you need in your veins to keep you going. And today, if you haven't gotten an idea of what we're gonna be recreating, I got like a whole little free lunch program going on right now. We're gonna be recreating Bagel Bite, a classic, an extreme snack. All right, if you skateboarded, all right, and then in the early 90s, late 90s, mid 90s, throughout the 90s, you've probably gotten very familiar with this snack. You know, I'm looking like D'Angelo, looking like an R&B singer. But you know what I'm here to do. We're gonna bust open this box, see what's up, see the inner workings. Bagel Bites come in multiple varieties, but in my small supermarket, they only carry two. We got the three cheese, and we got the party size cheese and pepperoni. The ones I'm gonna be making is one that's cheese and one that's pepperoni. This is a disclaimer, okay? I know there's gonna be so many people be like, oh my God, yo, that's not how you make bagels, because well, my cousin Ryan and them used to make the bagels with the, look, this is how I make bagels. I want this recipe to be as approachable as possible. So this is a very, very easy recipe, not a traditional bagel recipe at all. Hit the comments, keep the nasty down there, and I'll read them, and I'll feel some types of ways, and you know where to go if you want to do that. All right, Bagel Bites, let's open these up. So you have three different ways to cook this. You got oven, you got toaster oven, and you got a microwave, 1100 watts for a softer pizza bagel. Okay, so we're gonna preheat this to 425. We got that going on. We're gonna arrange 12 of them on a little cookie sheet. Oh, okay. Look at that. It's that astronaut food. You know what I'm saying? And that's how they come. All right, I'm not gonna cook all of these because that's insanity. But that's how they come. So the sauce is just dripping, oozing, bagoozing everywhere. I haven't really looked at these in so long. The bagels themselves, something to look at. They don't have big holes. They have very small ones. Okay. Very small little belly buttons. Look. They smell like a freezer. So, you know, because they came from the freezer. Let's line them up. Get them in that oven. And see what we're working with. All right. I pulled these out. They were in the oven for about 16 minutes, 425. And look at these, they're crispy. Ooh, ah, the little pepperoni. Ugh, pepperoni. Let's get into it. Okay, so some of them on the dry side, I could definitely tell. Like this guy. You know, just from the sauce being a little bit everywhere. Got this guy, got a little saucy Joe. This, I've been eyeing this one. Pepperoni, you can still see the cubes of the cheese, but it's melted pretty evenly. Pepperoni dough. And I had this, a Bagel Bite has not touched my lips since I was a sweet, sweet child of mine. A sweet little boy. Okay? Let's see. Flavor wise, tasting the pepperoni. Tasting a little bit of cheese. The bagel, the initial bite of it is crispy. And it's pretty mushy after that. I'm get a little bit like tartness from the tomato, but there's not too much going on. They're not horrible. They're Bagel Bites. So for me, I already know what I want to do with these, all right? I want the sauce. I want to hit that with some herbaceous flavor, all right? We're talking about oregano. We're talking about rosemary. We're talking about basil, salt, pepper, garlic, onions. I want to keep a little chunkiness in that sauce too. Because this just tastes like canned sauce. Local cheese, mozzarella cheese. Now for the bagels, like I said, it's not traditional bagels. I just want to put that in. Disclaimer. I want to add some flavor to that, so I might put a little flaky salt on top of it. Brush a little olive oil maybe, or maybe I'll just put some more Italian seasoning on top of it. While I eat this, I'm going to school you guys on the history of Bagel Bites. All right, so I got my red drink, got my Bagel Bites, I got a little ranch with a little Frank's Red Hot in it, okay? This is the part where I give you the history, the rundown of this legendary food, okay? Bagel Bites are synonymous with the 90s, all right? Extreme, X Games, Before Sunrise, Ethan Hawke,
white boys with hair like this, Family Matters, all that stuff. If you guys familiar with Bagel Bites, you've probably seen the famous commercial featuring Tony Hawk.
Whoa, Tony Hawk.
I've definitely known adults who've eaten Bagel Bites for breakfast, okay? Some of them probably still do. Get some help. Call this number. Get some help for you guys. But the actual conception of this is actually pretty interesting. I think it's pretty interesting. So it's two guys, Garskinski and Moshe. And they were friends. One of them, Moshe, was a caterer. He was in the food business, all right? Him and his sister. And Garskinski was a businessman, all right? He knew, he was behind the blinds. He was making the calls. He used to serve mini bagels at catering events, right? And this is what, when this happened, was in 1985, right? So he was in Beverly Hills, blowing people's minds, probably like, oh, I've never had this. These guys became friends over playing tennis with each other, living the good life. And no one was doing mini bagels, okay? So they set out on this venture, they joined forces, and they went out on this venture. Started in 1985, right? And these guys sold so much Bagel Bites, they were swimming in the money. We got something on our hands here. From 1985 to 1991, they made so much noise, and they rattled the industry so much, that Heinz stepped in, all right? And brought them for a whopping amount of money. It was in the millions. It was a lot of money. This looked like a mukbang right now. I'm gonna show you how to make Bagel Bites now. How I'm gonna do it. So you're gonna wanna get a mixing bowl. And to that, you're gonna wanna add 3 cups of bread flour. And you can substitute the bread flour for all-purpose flour if need be, but bread flour just has a little bit more oomph, so it gives it chewiness. Add 2 tablespoons of salt. I'm gonna do 1 tablespoon of white sugar and 1 whole tablespoon of instant dry yeast, active yeast, into that mixture. You know, just mix that up with a spoon. And from there, you're gonna have about 2 cups of warm water. This is what's gonna help activate the yeast. You might not need the whole 2 cups of warm water. So what you're gonna wanna do is just add bit by bit and stir with the spoon first till you start to get a nice shaggy dough. Stir, add a little bit of stir. It'll be soft. You want it to be tactile, you want it to be a little bit sticky, okay? So once you get a nice shaggy dough going, you're gonna wanna take that bowl, dump it on your table, and start kneading it by hand. You could do all this too in the KitchenAid, but I just like to feel that dough so I know the texture and what we're looking for. And you just knead it for a good 5 minutes. You're gonna wanna roll that into a ball, and you're gonna wanna lightly rub it with some olive oil, put it back into your mixing bowl, cover it with plastic wrap and let that rise for about an hour until it doubles in size, okay? To look like Eddie Murphy with the clumps. And while that's resting, you can work on your tomato sauce. It's a very easy, simple tomato sauce, okay? For the children, well, you're gonna need an onion. You're gonna need about 1/4 of an onion, 4 cloves of garlic, 15-ounce can of tomato sauce, unseasoned. And I add a little water to that, some olive oil, some salt, pepper, Italian seasoning, the good stuff. And about 4 or 5 leaves of basil, just nice, shifting on it, and I turn it, chop it up. Okay, and the first thing you wanna do with this is you wanna get a nice saucepan, nice saute pan. You're gonna hit that with about maybe 2-3 tablespoons of olive oil. Get that on medium heat, bring it up. Then you're gonna wanna saute your onions. For the white onions, I like to run my knife through it and chop it. Just to get them small, since we're gonna keep the sauce, we're not pureeing it or anything like that. You're gonna add that to the oil. For your garlic, I just like to mince it up. Add a little salt to it too, that helps break down the garlic. You'll saute that, you'll sweat that out for about 3-4 minutes until it starts to get nice and translucent, okay? And then you're gonna get your garlic and you're gonna add that to the pan and you're gonna saute that. And if it gets a little bit brown and like nutty in there, that's fine, we want that. It's like a nice roasted garlic flavor. Then you'll add your can of tomatoes, the tomato sauce. You'll stir that in there. I stir that up, put it to a little bit lower heat because it'll start bubbling up. Then I add some more salt, some pepper, my Italian seasoning, a good tablespoon of that stuff, okay? And you stir that up, you bring that up to a nice little simmer. You throw your basil in there, and you stir that up, and you take it off the heat, and you let that cool. okay? If you don't add too much water to the sauce, it should be thick enough to stick to the bagel. So you let that cool to the side. And then it's an hour later now. Now your bagels are ready to form. You got a nice squishy, double the size dough ball. You just put your finger in there and get a little squishy little belly button. So you take that out. You don't need any flour on your surface. If you got that dough nice and supple, you know, sticky and tactile, you can use a knife like a dull knife or dough scraper. You're gonna wanna cut 1.5 ounce little strips from that. It can get close to 2 ounces too, which is fine. You get them all cut up, and then you'll get your Play-Doh hands on. So you just make a snake, your Play-Doh snake. You do a little with your hand, you can do it on the table. So roll that snake out, you'll bring each end together, overlapping them, pinch them a little bit, stick your finger in the hole, and you'll just roll that over on your board to seal it. Right, they're not gonna look perfect. They don't look like little doodoo snakes, but that's okay. And then rest them. You let them rest for about 10 minutes on a piece of parchment paper. You just line it with a little bit of cooking spray, a little canola spray, canola. In the meantime, you're gonna wanna start boiling some water. You're gonna boil these in just plain water. You're gonna wanna bring that water up to a boil, medium-sized pot, then put it down to simmer. And once your bagels have risen, awakened, you don't wanna overcrowd your pan. You're gonna probably wanna do 3 to 4 bagels at a time. You'll plop them in, let one side cook for about 15 seconds, 10 seconds, flip them over, another 10 seconds, take them out, put them on a paper towel or towel lined sheet tray, and you just let that get cool enough to handle. Okay, it can still be a little warm, that's okay. Once you got that, you're gonna transfer them back onto your sheet tray that's lined with parchment paper and a little bit more that's cooking oil. And you can top it with any toppings you want. Anything you want, raisins, you know, anything. I put Italian, don't put raisins on it, don't do it. I put Italian seasoning on some, and I leave some with no Italian seasoning on, maybe a little salt, okay? And then you're gonna wanna bake those in your oven at 400 to 425 degrees for 15 to 20 minutes until it just gets nice and dark and looking scrumptious like a bagel. Once you pull them out, you look at that beautifulness, you're in shock and all, you take pictures on Instagram, you send it to your grandma, let that cool completely. Take a bagel, you'll get a bread knife or a knife, and you'll cut the bagel straight through, boop. You got 2 bagel bites now. You just dress those up with a little sauce. Hopefully that hole will be really small enough where you could just, don't even worry about it, just put like a nice amount of salt. Sauce, nothing too saucy. This is a thing that's too much sauce, okay? Put that, some cheese on hand. You can put pepperoni on hand. You can put ham on there. You can put pancetta. You can just put herbs. You can put a little diced eggplant squash. You're gonna wanna pop that in your oven at 425. About 7 minutes till the cheese gets oozy, the bottom of the bagel just gets crispier and crispier, and the fat from the pepperoni just dripping and oozing on the cheese, and that's how you know you made it to heaven. Okay, you open your eyes and there it is. You got bagel bites, bro. Look how easy that was. But if you got a big enough freezer and you're balling like that, you put them in a single layer and you freeze them on some parchment paper. Then from there, you just pop them in some Ziploc bags, right? For the kids, for the adults too, okay? Pop them in a Ziploc bag. You can make these later for any time. You get a Ziploc, you write bagel bites on it. Made by mom, dad, made by the kids. Ethan, I don't know why it's popping, you know, whatever. You just save it. All right, guys, this is it. The piece de resistance. The Mamma Mia moment. My rendition of pizza bagels, original bagel bites, the whole writer of bagel bites. So we got pepperoni here, of theirs. Come a little closer, look, you're gonna look at that. And we have my pepperoni version. Right there, look, glistening. Mm-hmm. Put a little extra lip gloss on. And then we got my cheese. And we got my cheese, you know, bigger. This is a bite. It is a nibble.
Nibble, bite. Nibble, bite. Bite, nibble. This one is calling me. What's my call for? That's it right there. Salty, herbaceous. Tastes like a slice of raised pizza. If you know, you know. All right, crunchy bagel. Not mushy. Some texture to it. The bread, it's like everything is layered, seasoned, layered perfectly. We got the salt and the sugar from the bagel. Taste that in there. You got the salt and that sweet tartness from the tomato. You got the super salty pepperoni and the delicious unctuous cheese, okay? This is better. Mine is better, 100%. I would definitely make these over that. And this bagel recipe is 1,000,000,000% easy. You can make this earlier in the day. It'll be done before lunchtime, okay? So an hour or two, really. Pizza bagels, Tony Hawk, pro skater. What does it all mean? I don't know. Pizza bagels, I can never go back. 2021, and this is the new pizza bagel. I put that in, okay? I love you guys. Like, subscribe, Nappy Fried Chicken. Two eyes in the fry. Follow me. I've been, look at my life. See what I do. I'm on the beach. Some pictures I'm sitting on my couch. And you can just see how I live, all right? Delish. I love you guys. This is Rome. Out. Peace. Childhood Eats.